Hey everybody, this is Nick. I am going to give you a really quick follow-up tip to our last video on how you can make an updating chart that will update with the last 12 months of data that you enter into a range. Now, this comes from my sister Kate, who asked the question if we could create this type of chart. And in the previous video, we showed you how to create that type of chart from scratch using the offset function in Excel. It's super easy, much easier than I thought it might be. But now comes the tricky part. What if you have to give this spreadsheet over to your staff or to someone else who has to update the chart? But you don't want them to be mucking around with the cells, especially in that data range, the offset formula for the chart. So what we're going to do is we're going to protect this range, we're going to lock this range of cells, and we're going to allow this range of cells to continue to be added to by anyone who enters, by anyone who goes into the spreadsheet and needs to enter their data. So let's first go over here. I want to show you this. We're going to go ahead and select the data range that you want to protect. And let's go ahead and right click and go to the Format Cells tab right here. Now you'll see this is where it'll probably pop up here. This is where you can change the number format, all that stuff. But if you go over here to the Protection tab, you can see that locked cells, that right here, this little locked checkbox is already clicked by default. We want those cells to be locked. So we're going to keep those okay. And now these cells right here are the ones that we want people to be updating. But I know that they're going to be updating things below here in these columns. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to select these two columns, select any of the columns that you want people to be able to update. And we're going to go back, we're going to right click, go to Format Cells, and instead of under the Protection tab, you'll probably see that Locked is set by default. We're going to unselect that. So make sure that Locked is unselected there. We're going to go ahead and click OK. Now we're going to protect this worksheet. So go down to the tab number 3 right here, whatever your tab worksheet is called. We're going to say right click, and then we're going to say Protect Sheet. Now you can see that it's already selected to protect worksheet and contents of locked cells. So we want that to happen. And then it says allow all users of this workbook to select locked cells. No, we don't want them to select locked cells. So we're going to unselect that if that was selected. And we do want them to be able to select unlocked cells. So we're going to do that. And if you wanted to type in a password, you could also do that. So I'm going to type in my password. I'm just going to make it my sister's name, Kate, K-A-T-E. I'm going to say OK. And now we're going to re-enter the password, click OK. And now you can see right here in my sheet, now this is a protected sheet. I'm clicking around right now and nothing, I can click on nothing. I can't click on anything in this cell. I'm not gonna be able to change or update any of these data. But as soon as I click into any of these cells in column B and C, you can see that I still can. So now down here, I can enter my new data, 25, 100%, oops. 100% there, and you can see my chart updates here, but I still can't click in any of these cells, but I can update these cells right here. Super, super cool. So if you like this trick, I hope that it works, and I hope that you protect your cells so that nobody else can change your chart data. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and make sure to click the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. I had a great time making this for you, and I can't wait to see you all next time.